Good morning, family. You're welcome into the presence of God this morning. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this opportunity to come into your presence again. Thank you, God, that day by day you draw us into your presence so that you can enrich us with your word and shower us with amazing blessings. God, we thank you today because, Father, we can truly say that we are your children because, God, you cause us to approach you, O Lord. And so, Father, today as we come with expectation that, Lord, as we come before you, that God, we will never leave empty, oh God. You say, come as you are, but whenever we live, oh God, we have the fragrance of our Father God. And so we thank you today and we honor your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much, guys. So let us go into the presence of God with music and singing. Let us worship the Lord this morning.
There is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like you. There is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. I could search for all eternity long and find there is none like you.
Your mercy flows like the
take your glory, Lord of Lords. Take your glory, King of Kings. It belongs to you alone. Sing.
Take your glory, King of Kings.
Take all the glory.
Take your glory, Lord of Lords.
Oh,
take your glory, King of Kings.
It belongs to you.
Amen. We give thanks to God for that time in worship with music. And now we'll go into our session for general prayers, and our sister Winifred will be leading us in today's general prayers. You're welcome, Sister Winifred.
Hallelujah. Good morning. We thank God for He's been our Ebenezer. He has brought us this far, ushered us into January 2023 and to end of it today. So this morning we'll be praying together for the morning devotion program. Our prayer is for God's enlargement and deliverance this year, 2023. So we are praying together for this morning devotion program. So the first prayer, let us thank God for His marvelous hand of help toward this morning devotion program throughout the year 2022. First Chronicles 16:8 says, give thanks unto the Lord, call upon His name, make known His deeds among the people. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. Everlasting Lord, Savior and Redeemer, we thank you. Thank you, O Lord, my God. Thank you for all the help you rendered toward us this on this morning devotion program throughout the year 2022. We thank you, our Father, for you are a good God. Thank you for your love, which endures forever. Thank you, O Lord, for your protection and your provision for us in the year 2022. Thank you, O Lord, for your mercies that are always new every day. Psalm 124 says, our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Therefore, Lord, this morning, our help is in you. We are looking up unto you. We say thank you. Thank you for all help to us on this platform. We are grateful, O Lord. We praise and exalt your holy name. We worship and we magnify you, O Lord, for you are a good God. Lord, we say thank you. Father, we bless your holy name. Thank you, O Lord, because you are a merciful God. You are a good God. Thank you for that which you've done. Thank you for that which you will do this year. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. And now we go to prayer number two. Let us thank God for his wings of protection over this morning devotion program and for sustaining the health of every member of this platform in the year 2022. Psalm 36:7 says, how precious is your loving kindness, O God, and the children of men take refuge in the shadow of your wings. We thank you, Lord. Father, we give thanks unto you for your unfailing love. Thank you for your hand of protection and care over every member. In this year 2023, we know you will do it again. Thank you, O Lord, for your faithfulness, for your word for us that says, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Under your wings there we shall be forever, and there we shall abide, secure and safe. We thank you, O Lord. Thank you for your wings of protection over us. We worship you, Lord. We bless your holy name. Lord, we praise you. Oh, Father, we bless your holy name. We just say thank you. We are with you. We are saying thank you. We are saying thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed this morning. Amen. And prayer number three says, let us thank God for the 2023 prophetic word of enlargement and deliverance for this morning devotion program and in the life of every participant. Let us thank God in advance because he will fulfill it. He will fulfill it. Lord, we thank you. Thank you for your prophetic word of enlargement and deliverance for this morning devotion. Thank you, Father, because in this year 2023, you will increase us. We shall grow numerically. Thank you, Father, for that which you have done, for that which you will do in our midst this year. Oh, Lord, we thank you. Your word in Obadiah says, there is deliverance in Zion. Therefore, this morning, oh Lord, we know that you will deliver us. We know that you will keep us. Thank you, oh Lord, for there shall be deliverance and enlargement on this program in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, God of multiplication. You will multiply us and continue to increase us, and we can all have cause to give thanks unto your name. In the name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. Now we go to prayer number four. Our Father, let your mighty hand, let it rest upon this morning devotion program. And by it, let every opposition to our enlargement and deliverance be brought down and trodden underfoot. Immediately, in Jesus Christ's name, let us pray. Our Father, our deliverer, we ask now, O Lord, my God, with your right hand, your mighty hand, to rest upon this program and break every hold of the enemy against the growth of this morning devotion program. You are bigger than what men say, O Lord. Therefore, all oppositions against our growth and enlargement is being brought down. Now, in the name of Jesus, Isaiah 25:10 says, for in this mountain shall the hand of the Lord rest, and Moab shall be trodden down under him, even as straw is trodden down for the dunghill, and he shall spread forth his hand in the midst of them, as he that swimmeth spreadeth forth his hand to swim, and he shall bring down their pride together with the spoils of their hands and the fortress of the high fort. For thy wall shall be brought down, lay low and bring down, even to the ground, to the dust. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Lord, we thank you because we know you will do it for us in Jesus' mighty name. Now let us go to prayer number five. Let us, by the blood of Jesus, destroy all objects and incidences of distraction the devil is using against the growth of this morning devotion program, and bring to naught all his wiles against us in Jesus' name. Revelation 12, 11 says, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto death. Oh, my Father, my God, our Father and our God, every wiles of the enemy against this morning devotion program, we bring it down. Every form of distraction and disturbances on this platform are being destroyed and brought to naught by that power in the blood of Jesus. By that power in the blood of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. Father, we thank you because you are more than able. You will do it, and you will destroy every forces of disturbance on this platform. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. Prayer number 6 now. It says, let us destroy every plan and agenda of the devil against the fulfillment of the prophetic word of enlargement and deliverance concerning this morning devotion program and all the participants this year. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we destroy every schemes of the enemy against us for our enlargement and deliverance. We evoke that power in the blood of Jesus to destroy every power of darkness against the prosperity of this morning devotion program. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in by the power and the blood of Jesus, we destroy every schemes of the enemy against the growth of this morning devotion program. In the name of Jesus. Job 5:12 says, he disappointed the devices of the crafty so that their hands can perform their enterprise. So that their hands cannot perform their enterprise. Their hands will not be able to perform their enterprise on this program in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever schemes, whatever ways they come against us, they shall be destroyed by that power in the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Now we go to our last prayer, prayer number 7. It says, Father, visit this morning devotion program this year by yourself and greatly enrich us with the river of God, making us strong for yourself on all fronts in Jesus' name. Make us strong for yourself in the mighty name of Jesus. And 80:14 says, return, we beseech thee, O God of hosts. Look down from heaven and behold and visit this vine and the vineyard which thy right hand had planted, and the branch that thou made strong for thyself. We thank you, O Lord. Heavenly Father, we ask that you bless this morning devotion program for us. We open, O Lord, open all the floodgates of heaven and pour out your blessing upon us on this program in the mighty name of Jesus. Psalm 65:9 says, thou visitest the earth and waterest in. Thou greatly enriches in with the river of God, which is full of water. Thou preparest them corn when thou hast provided for it. And all after that has made it, thou waterest the riches thereof abundantly. Thou settlest the furrows thereof. Thou makest it soft with showers. Thou blessest the spring thereof. There shall be showers of blessings in the mighty name of Jesus. All that you will do for us in this year, we will come back and testify and give praise and glory unto your holy name. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, O Lord, for this time in your presence. We thank you, O Lord, because you are doing it already. We thank you, O Lord, because we can trust in you. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Father, we thank you because you are our refuge and fortress. Shield us and preserve us this morning. Shield us on this morning devotion program. And we thank you, Heavenly Father, because we have victory in you. Help us to continue to grow spiritually, and continue to increase us numerically on this morning devotion platform, just as you added to them daily in the book of Acts. We worship you, O Lord, and we bless your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, God. And we thank God for answers to prayers this morning. Our Bible reading today will come from the book of Luke, chapter 7, verse 1 to 10. Luke 7, verse 1 to 10. Our sister Lydia Olembo will be reading for us. You're welcome, Sister Lydia.
Good morning, family. Thank you, Sister Lydia. I'm reading from Luke chapter 7, verses 1 to 10. Now, when he had ended all his saying in the audience of the people, he entered into Capernaum, and a certain centurion's servant who was dear unto him was sick and ready to die. And when he heard of Jesus, he sent unto him the elders of the Jews, beseeching him that he would come and heal his servant. And when they came to Jesus, they besought him instantly, saying that he was worthy for whom he should do this. For he loveth our nation, and he hath built us a synagogue. Verse 6. Then Jesus went with them, and when he was now not far from the house, the centurion sent friends to him, saying unto him, Lord, trouble not thyself, for I am not worthy that thou shouldest enter under my roof. Wherefore, neither thought I myself worthy to come unto thee, but say in a word, and my servant shall be healed. For I also am a man set under authority, having under me soldiers. And I say unto one, go, and he goeth, and to another, come, and he cometh, and to my servant, do this, and he doeth. When Jesus heard these things, he marveled at him, and turned him about, and said unto the people that followed him, I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel. And they that were sent returning to the house found the servant whole that had been sick. The word of God for the people of God. Amen.
Amen. Amen. This morning, we will receive our charge from our brother, George Matthew. Brother Matthew, you're welcome.
Thank you. Thank you. Good morning to everyone that is on the platform this morning. I want to take the opportunity to thank Pastor Tunji for giving me the opportunity again to bring the charge this morning. I pray God will give Pastor Tunji more grace to continue this program to benefit us all and our family. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. Let your word come and let the word manifest through us, O Lord. Open our hearts, open our spirit to hear the word, open our ears to also hear in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' mighty name. As we have heard, the scripture today is from Luke 7, verse 1 to 10. And the title of this message this morning is called Great Faith Moves the Kingdom of God. And in Luke 7, verse 2 to 4 states that and a centurion slave who was highly regarded by him was sick and about to die. 3, when he heard about Jesus, he sent some of his Jewish elders and asking him to come and save the life of his slave. When they came to Jesus, they earnestly implored him, saying, he is worthy for you to grant him this favor. In Matthew 6:33, it says, search for the kingdom of God, and everything else will be added unto us. And we think, go back to the scripture, Luke 7, verse 5 to 7, which states, for he loves our nation, and it was he who built us our synagogue. You know, you see what he was, although he was not a Jew, but he was helping the Jew building the synagogue. Now Jesus started on his way with them. And when he was not too far away from the house, the centurion sent friends saying to him, Lord, do not trouble yourself further, for I am not worthy for you to come under my roof. Ah, this is a lot of humility. He's not worthy. Seven said, for this reason, I did not even come to consider myself worthy to come to you. Praise the Lord. But just say the word, and my servant will be healed. We thank you, Lord, for this word. And if we go to 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 36, that is the story about David and Goliath. And you know, the message title is Great Faith Moves the Kingdom of God. In 1 Samuel 17, 36 states, David said to Goliath, you uncircumcised Philistine, for he has defiled the armies of the living God of Israel. In verse 40 says, then he took his staff in his hand and he chose for himself five smooth stones from the brook and put them in a shepherd's bag in a porch where he had, and his sling was in his hand, and he drew near to the Philistine. 43 says, so the Philistine said to David, am I a dog that you come to me with sticks? And the Philistine cursed David by his God. That agitated David more, you know. In 45 says, you come with swords, javelin, and everything else, but I come in the Lord's who you have defiled. The Lord will deliver you into my hand. For the battle, again, the battle is the Lord. He will deliver you in our hands. David ran towards the battle line. He did not backtrack. He went towards the battle line. The Philistine. David put a stone and swung it and struck Goliath in his forehead, and he fell down to the ground, and Goliath was dead. And you know what happened next? David drew his own sword, Goliath's sword, and cut his neck and take it to Saul, the king. And Nehemiah, the story of Nehemiah, we have gone through it, but I'm not going to go to it in detail, but there was a challenge in Jerusalem. And Nehemiah 2 verse 16 to 18 says, 16 says, he went to Jerusalem to fix the gates or the temple and so on. When he got there, he got permission because he was a cupbearer. So he got permission from the king and he went down to Jerusalem. When he got to Jerusalem, he did not tell anyone. And David did all his investigation at night. He went, he did everything, know what was the challenge, where he should start the program at night. He did not even tell the magistrate. He didn't even tell the workers that's supposed to do the work. And he went through. He had challenges, both left and right, but he kept to his course, what he wanted to do, to achieve. And in verse 17 said, then I said to them, you see the bad situation we are in, how Jerusalem lies in ruin and his gates are burned with fire. Come, let us build the wall of Jerusalem that we may no longer be a disgrace. So he had challenges, but he kept doing what he came to Jerusalem to do. He eventually built that wall. And we go to Esther. We go back to, to the scripture. Luke 7, chapter 8 and 10. Verse 8 and 10, he said, "For I am a man, I'm placed under authority with soldiers under me. And I said to this one, go, and he will go. And to the other, come, and he will come. And to my slave, do this, and he does it." Now, when Jesus heard this, he marveled at him and turned to the people with him, and I assume the disciples was with him, and said to you, "Even in Israel have I found such a great faith." When those who had heard him returned to the house, they found the slave in good health. And you can see that great faith. Jesus talked about great faith. But let's go back to Mark 4, verse 40 to 41. When Jesus was in the boat and the sea was really rough, the disciples called him. And you know what Jesus said? "Why are you afraid? You have not even little faith, no faith." And in Luke 13, verse 18 to 21, he was saying, "What is the kingdom of God like? And what he should compare it with?" And he said, "Like a mustard seed." A mustard seed is the smallest seed, and the gardener threw it, a man threw it in the garden, and it grew and became a big tree. And in that big tree, you have birds that nest in it. And in Matthew 18, verse 18 to 20, he says, "Whatever we bind on earth is also bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth is loose in heaven." Again, that is the power. That is the faith. We cannot just say this word, but we have to believe and have faith, and it will move the kingdom of God. So we go to Esther. Esther 4, verse 15 to 17. And you know the challenges with Haman and Mordecai. And Haman wanted all the Jews to be killed. So Mordecai told Esther, "You cannot run away from the situation, even though you are in the king's palace." So Esther sent message to Mordecai and said, "Go gather all the Jews and have them fast for 3 days and 3 nights. And myself and my servant will do likewise." What I want you to hear now is what Esther said. "And so I will go to the king, which is against the law." At that time, you know what? You just open the door and go to the king. You are a dead person. And what she said, "If I perish, I perish. If I perish, I perish." And we all know the story. Everything worked well, and the victory, again, faith will move the kingdom of God. You'll give us favor on either side. Let's get to the story of the rich young ruler. That is in Luke 18, verse 22 to 25. Jesus did not, the ruler came to Jesus and said, "What should I do to be saved?" Jesus told him that you should not commit adultery, you should love your parents and all the rest. And he said, "I have done all these things." So Jesus said, only one thing you have to do is to sell everything that you have and follow me, and your treasures will be in heaven. The young ruler was very, very disappointed because he was very rich. He was extremely rich, according to the Bible. Jesus said that it's difficult for a wealthy person to enter the kingdom of God. But Jesus said, the things that are impossible with people are possible with God. So I want to end the message by encouraging every one of us here today. In Luke 12, 30 to 32, said, we should search for the kingdom of God first, and everything else will be added unto us. Brethren, let us take this into consideration. Even when we are leaving the house, we should pray so that God will make a way where there is no way. Every crooked path will be straightened. So let's seek the kingdom of God, and we will be fine, in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for the opportunity. God bless us, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. Faith is key in everything we do with God, particularly for the kingdom of God. He said, great faith moves the kingdom. One thing I noticed, I wrote down in my note here, this man was not even a Jew, was Roman. But God saw his acts of faith. He said, he has been involved in helping, or he has been helping to build the synagogue. He has been helping in sustaining the work of the synagogue. Hence, when he was in need, God responded. How much more will a child of God, to a child of God, would God respond when we get engaged in the building of his house? Everything you do with God, you need faith. Now we go before the Lord our God, in expressing our confidence, our faith again in him for the day, and asking for his help as we go through this day, asking for his help, because God is the helper of our destinies. Let's go before the Lord this morning. I know you have things you want to present before the Lord. I know you have things you want to say to him. That's why I say this morning devotion moment, this personal moment is very important. It gives you the opportunity to open up yourself before the Lord and say it to him the way you want. We'll be back together shortly. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We thank God for the privilege of his presence and the privilege of answered prayers. Keep stretching your faith. Keep putting it out on the line for his kingdom. God rewards acts of faith. Amen. That's what he does. I said it, I think it was yesterday. A citizen of the kingdom of God walks in love and lives by faith. He said, the just shall live by his faith. One time he asked them, where is your faith? How long will I be with you? Where is your faith? Because it takes faith to perform. It takes faith to accomplish. It takes faith to do. It takes faith to overcome. It is all by faith or nothing. So get your faith out. He said, above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith thou shalt be able to quench all the fiery darts of the devil. Pull your faith out. When anything confronts you, know that it is not out there to destroy you, but all that it takes of you to overcome is your faith. By faith we stand. Always know that God honors faith. Amen? It is well with you. Let's have Sister Winifred close us this morning.
Thank you, Father. Well, we've had it. Hebrews 11 says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. We have to start living by faith. I'm talking to myself, and I keep praying, Lord, do not let my faith fail me, just as Jesus prayed for them. Faith without works is dead faith. Christianity is all about faith. So let's keep walking in faith. We thank God for this morning devotion. Let us keep inviting people to this platform where they can come and be refreshed, just as we get refreshed daily, and God will help us. Remember that this program runs Monday through Friday, 5 a.m. Mountain Time. And we gather here, we praise him, we worship, and we go our ways, being blessed every day. Thank you very much, everyone. And until we meet tomorrow, let's go out again there and be the church. Now let's share the fellowship together. The goodness, surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we continue to dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. God bless us all.